As the protesters roared in Tahrir Square in Egypt, President Obama and his top national security advisors were hunkered down in the Situation Room of the White House, trying to game out an incredibly volatile and complicated situation, the vanilla statements coming from the State Department podium notwithstanding.
We are monitoring it very closely and continue to believe that, of course, the Egyptian people deserve a peaceful political solution to the current crisis.
Hours after Egyptian President Mohamed Morsy was removed from power by the military, President Obama released a carefully worded statement. And what he did not say might have mattered most. He avoided using the word coup. He didn't call on the Egyptian military to restore power to the democratically elected civilian government, but rather to a democratically elected civilian government. In other words, not necessarily President Mohamed Morsi's government.
They are a new government that is trying to find its way.
The president has yet to appear before the cameras or comment publicly on this Middle East maelstrom, but back in September, the president highlighted the rocky relationship with the Morsi government in an interview with Telemundo.
You know, I don't think that we would consider them an ally, but we don't consider them an enemy.
The thinking of the president now, according to a knowledgeable source, is that while the administration is not explicitly supporting the removal of Morsi from power, they hope they can push the military in a new direction. If the president had used the word coup, there might be legal ramifications, a legal requirement to eliminate U.S. aid, as General Martin Dempsey explained to CNN's Candy Crowley just before Morsi was deposed.
If this were to be seen as a coup, then it would limit our ability to have the kind of relationship we think we need with the Egyptian armed forces.
Currently, the U.S. gives $1.5 billion to Egypt annually, mostly in military aid. In his statement, the president said he directed a review of the implications under U.S. law for our assistance to the government of Egypt. Could that aid disappear? He never says. He just raises the subject and then leaves it there. And that just may be the point, to push the Egyptian military to hold new elections as soon as possible, a process that should include, the president said, supporters of the Muslim Brotherhood.
A coup by any other name is a coup.
So while what happened in Egypt fits the definition of a military coup, don't expect to hear that four-letter word from President Obama, or at least not yet.
All this hedging by the Obama administration may not matter much ultimately to the anti-Morsi crowds in the street. They viewed the relationship between the White House and Morsi's government as too cozy, which is why anti-America and anti-Obama signs popped up at protests over there.